Marlene Hutchinson, and welcome to Tips for Guitar Playing Success. As many of you know, I've been sharing my guitar playing tips every Thursday for more than 8 years. It's been my way to hopefully help you stay motivated, be inspired, and continue expanding your guitar playing journey. If you're interested in more learning resources like my Thursday Tips blog, my DVDs, books, virtual learning, and more, go to my website, marlenesmusic.com. And for anyone who's listening and feels like you're missing out on all the fun, you can easily join our wonderful world of guitar with my Learn to Play Guitar in a Day program, which you can also find at marlenesmusic.com. Now on to today's tip. Today's tip is learn, play, and master chord progressions. Chord progressions are great to know and, of course, to play. But you might be thinking, what is a chord progression? Chord progressions start with chords. A chord is usually 2 to 3 notes played together rather than playing a single note. When the chords are played in sequence, you've got a chord progression. When you play the chord progressions in a repetitive sequence, you've got a song. Now, there's a formula to chord progressions, and I'll go over that in the simplest way. It's a numbering system. The most common sequence is 1, 4, and 5. This sequence is often called the Nashville numbering system. It's an easy way for musicians to work together when they know this system. What the numbers represent is 1, the root chord, 4, the fourth chord in the scale, and 5, the fifth chord in the scale. You might be thinking, what is a scale? Well, a scale is a chromatic scale, and it's a musical scale broken into 12 pitches. So, if the root chord is C, then the fourth is F, and the fifth is G. So, a 1-4-5 chord progression in the key of C would be C, F, and G. Chord progressions are designed to be a template for songs, and there are countless varieties of chord progressions. Some common 3-chord chord progressions are A, D, and E, C, F, and G, as I just mentioned, D, G, and A, and G, C, and D. Some common 4-chord chord progressions are A, D, E, A, C, F, G, C, D, G, A, D, E, A, B, E. You'll find these progressions in songs like Happy Birthday, Free Falling by Tom Petty, The Joker by Steve Miller, Brave by Sarah Bareilles, and Cruise by Florida Georgia Line, to name a few. Now, how can you use these chord progressions to benefit your playing? The best thing is to play them repetitively and become super familiar with these common chord progressions. So let's do that right now. Grab your guitar and let's play together. Let's start with A, D, and E. So play A, D, E, A, D, E, A, D, E, repetitively and really become familiar with that. Then move on to the next one, C, F, G, C, F, G, C, F, G. Same thing with the 4-chord chord progressions. So let's do A, D, E, A. A, D, E, A, A, D, E, A, A, D, E, A. So the idea is really to continue playing them over and over so you become familiar with them and your fingers will become familiar with these chords. Plus, you'll build the muscle memory of changing from chord to chord. I would also recommend that you explore the chord progressions within your songs because they are there. You'll usually find that the first three or four chords of a song are generally the progression that was used to write the song, and it may be one of these common chord progressions that I've just shared with you. Or it may be different from some of the common chord progressions because there are many chord progressions that you could do. Either way, you typically will see a pattern, and that pattern of chords is the progression. And here's a cool thing to think about. Much of the music that you listen to likely started as a chord progression. I hope this episode's tip has helped you to continue expanding your guitar skills and knowledge. If you'd like to learn more, check out the many learning resources available at my website, marlenesmusic.com. Thank you for joining today's podcast, and as I like to say, play on.